Good evening. Today, our fellow citizens, our way of life, our very freedom came under attack in a series of deliberate and deadly terrorist acts. The victims were in airplanes or in their offices, secretaries, businessmen and women, military and federal workers, moms and dads, friends and neighbors.
Appear that there's any kind of an effort up there yet. Now remember, oh my God.
That looks like a second plane.
I did not see a plane go in. That just exploded.
We just saw another plane coming in from the side.
You did. That was out of absolute.
Yes, and that's
view.
The second explosion. You could see the plane come in just from the right-hand side of the screen.
Good evening. Tonight, I can report to the American people and to the world that the United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda, and a terrorist who's responsible for the murder of thousands of innocent men, women, and children.
The reason terrorists were able to gain control of our planes was because of the lack of security in airports. Before 9/11, security was run by private companies. If you were boarding a plane on 9/11, you could bring blades up to 4 inches. You could also bring baseball bats, box cutters, darts, knitting needles, and scissors. With these embarrassing rules, the events of 9/11 were bound to happen. In fact, the rules made after 9/11 may even be too harsh. For example, if you would like to travel over plane now, you have to go through security check. This includes scanning all bags through an infrared scanner looking for bombs or other harmful weapons. You are also unable to take liquids over the size of 3.4 ounces. This rule was actually made in 2006 after there was an attempt of putting a bomb inside of a sports drink that was 32 ounces. Finally, all airport security is now run by TSA, or Transportation Security Administration. TSA is an agency of the U.S. Department of Homeland Security. The Homeland Security was created by George Bush about 1 year after the events of 9/11. They deal with border security, immigration, customs, cyber threats, and most of all, terrorists. Their main purpose is to prevent terrorist attacks from happening in the United States. Homeland Security often works with the FBI and CIA to get intel on terrorists that could be threats to the U.S. This graph shows how terrorist attacks have decreased over the years since 9/11. The real question is, are we safer and more prepared for another mass terrorist attack? There has not been a terrorist attack as big as 9/11 since. It is also nearly impossible to take weapons on board with you. And finally, airport security is much more advanced than it was on 9/11. Retired Coast Guard Admiral James Loy said, "We hardened cockpit doors to prevent hijackings, so the terrorists use shoe bombs to penetrate our defenses. When we began screening for shoe bombs, the terrorists turned to liquid explosives hidden in sports drink. And in 2006, they nearly succeeded in blowing up 7 planes crossing the Atlantic using such measures." Another big reason it is hard for terrorists to now take control of airplanes is because pilots go through physical training to defend themselves and passengers. Also, some pilots went through special training to carry a .40-caliber semi-automatic pistol. If somebody does threaten the lives of someone on the plane, pilots are allowed to shoot back and protect themselves and other passengers on the plane. 9/11 was a very sad day for everybody living in the United States of America.
None of us will ever forget this day, yet we go forward to defend freedom and all that is good and just in our world. Thank you, good night, and God bless America.